18G, right down the aisle to your left.
Thank you.
Thanks for your patience.
I figured you'd be in first class. Me too. But you're not sitting here. You're kidding. You're not kidding. You need a bellhop?
Please.
You okay?
You sure?
I'm cutting you off anyway, sorry. So, what are the odds, huh? Wait a minute. You're not stalking me, are you? I'm sorry. You all right? No, that's your dad's department. I see. Well, I feel terrible now. I do.
Ladies and gentlemen, we know it's been a long night, so if you'll stow your belongings and take your seats as quickly as possible, we'll be underway. Thanks.
So much.
You're welcome.
Just when I thought there weren't any gentlemen left.
Pleasant flight. Oh my. Oh, I saw that. Very nice of you. Isn't usually like this. Hey, what's up? Yeah, no, it's okay. So it's definitely happening? Uh-huh. 5:30. Okay, done deal. Work for the last time.
Folks from the flight deck, looks like we're the red eye to Miami, so welcome aboard. The weather conditions may cause us to have a bumpy takeoff, but don't worry, we'll soon climb above it. We'll see if we can't make up a little lost time once we're in the air. We're number one for departure. Flight attendant, secure the cabin for takeoff.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've been cleared for takeoff. Please enjoy your flight.
is Henrietta your mom's mom or your dad's mom? Are you folks still together? So your mom? I see. And his dad still work? Okay, so he's filling all his work time with... Does he have reason to worry about you? You mean, usually when things are going perfectly, you're back on track, everything's going to plan, and then one day, out of nowhere, somebody forgets to bolt the engine to the wing.
Well, folks, this is your captain. We're through the worst of it, so you can relax. I'd like you to keep your seatbelt securely fastened while seated as we may hit more turbulence. Thank you.
It's not really what I'm doing. Just keeping the focus on you and your father. Part of my job. Now, manager. No. Giving you cause to buy another self-help book. Government overthrows, flashy, high-profile assassinations, the usual. I'm a lousy shot. Well, if I did, I couldn't say, could I? No. The money's shit. I already did. What? No, I'm not suicidal. And you're right, you know, most days it is my own business. But right now, as fate would have it, my business is all about you. That's right. Charles Keefe, one of your regular VIPs, ring a bell? Yes, it should, because right now he's on his way to your hotel. That's why you need to keep listening. Yes, you do, if you want your dad to live. You heard me. K.R. Joe Reiser, your father?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't get it. My associate grabbed it off your dad's desk, apparently next to your graduation picture. JR, definitely dad's wallet, his initials. But gee, mine too. Jack Rittner, credit card, license. But for some reason, the stewardess, this emotionally unstable, rather inebriated girl I've never met before tonight, suddenly went crazy when I took it out of my pocket. You tell the flight attendant, and your dad dies. You might want to buckle up.
Hi.
Hi.
What can I do for you?
Did you need another pillow or anything? She's just had a really rough day. The death of a family.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I'll get you water and some tissues.
Thanks.
Be right back.
Thank you. That was great. Keep doing the right thing, huh? Just bottle the emotions a little more, okay? There you go. And it'll stay that way as long as you keep playing along.
for your Kleenex and water, and once we have our privacy, we can get back to business.
Here you go.
Oh, thank you so much.
Sure. Feel better, huh?
Just use your managerial pull to move key from 3825 to suite 4080. I'll leave the details to you. You just sell it. Well, I happen to know that you do, and I happen to know that you're the only voice that can get this done by the time I need it done. You need me to write it down? Well, then what's the delay? Silver Beamer parked outside 9321 Blossom Palms Lane. He's sitting in the dark listening to a little smooth jazz while he sharpens his 12-inch K-bar. That's a knife. Sure, after you make the call.
I hope that's yes, because that's the best I can do now. Let's get this over with.
Excuse me, I'm sorry. Can you help me again? Last time, I promise.
Sure.
Don't get cute.
complicated. I have to assume she's gonna read that. I want you to get excited about your life, but you gotta get real. I'm challenging you, starting now, to stop dealing in opinions and assumptions and start dealing in facts. In fact, fearing to act is failing to act is just plain dumb. In fact, thinking when you should be acting will likely make your head hurt. I'm not making this up. It's right here. Fact. You've been out for half an hour. Keith's room still hasn't been changed. So, I got you some aspirin. I need you coherent.
Well, folks, we were hoping things would calm down, but obviously that's not happening. So patrols just cleared us up to 35,000 feet. Let's see if we can't get above this weather and smooth things up.
Well, let's do this. I call, Dad wakes up, puts on coffee, never suspects a thing. You go back to work, life goes on. I am now calling your hotel. Good. Cynthia! Huh. Pretty clear thinking given the circumstances. Let me guess, some stress management courses. Well, they're really paying off. To get out of this, I may have to steal you. Excuse me, miss?
Yes?
The phone's not working.
Oh, they sometimes cut out during storms. They'll probably come back when we find some clear air.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Blame your grandmother. She keeled over, you hopped on the next flight out, Keith changed his plans, and here we are. You bury your dad in a closed casket.
well, sometimes bad things happen to good people. Like you. You know, I've known you for a while now. Before tonight, I mean. And far as I can tell, your life revolves around your job. The occasional cocktail at the corner cafe. The classic late night movies. Oh, and scrambled eggs at 3 a.m. What turned you into such a loner? Was your parents' divorce? Wait, did someone break your heart? Best I can do. I trust you. Not that much. Twice in accepting these little communiques. You know, if they'd have fallen into the hands of a by-the-book stewardess, she'd have gone straight to the cockpit, and we'd landed somewhere else. If that happened, our guy in the BMW's gonna know about it, so do Dad a favor and stop gambling with his life. Someone do that to you? You're not such an honest person. Because I've followed you for 8 weeks now, and I never once saw you order anything in the fucking sea breeze.
I never lied to you.
Oh, why? Because it doesn't serve me. We're both professional. We have the will and the means to follow through. If we don't, our customers aren't happy. And when they're not, we suffer, and our lives go to shit. And that's not going to happen. Is it? Good. Because I'm gonna tell you, the phones are working again. Are you sure we got a deal this time?
Motel.
Sure. Lose something?
Yes, my book.
I need you to pull yourself together. We seem to have attracted a little attention. Once they've made their rounds, we'll make the call.
The captain has turned on the fasten seatbelt sign. Please return to your seats as soon as possible. Thank you. Trash.
History. Your dad will be safe.
somebody wants to send a big, brash message, that's their business. I do my part, move on.
Gate, I'll follow you into the terminal. We'll hit Starbucks, grab a couple of lattes, kill 10 to 15 minutes till I get the call that keeps me taken out. And then I'll walk out of your life. Oh. Once I'm out of your line of sight, I'll call off Mr. Killer from outside Dad's, and then you're free. Pretty yell and scream, call your dad, tell him to run to the neighbors. Sound good? Want no questions? Best question you've asked all night. That it was beyond control.